folks, Larry here, Mobile Tech with CannedHamTrailers.com. Today we're going to install a ceiling vent, but it's not just any ceiling vent, it's a Fan-Tastic fan ceiling vent. Now I just got done installing one in the bathroom, and first thing I want to tell you is, right out of the box, this is the book that they give you, and it tells you in great detail how to use your Fan-Tastic fan. And it does it in 5 or 6 different languages. So, and it tells you how to, it really goes into great detail on the wall mount control, which is a remote control, which this one didn't come with one. I guess you have to pay extra for that. So it's, this one's just got the controls that are on the fan, on the unit itself. So we won't be going into any of that stuff really. This one is equipped with a rain sensor. There's not a rain sensor in the bathroom, and that's because you have steam and stuff that's moisture that's coming up, going to get sucked up out of the bathroom because there's a shower, and that will activate the rain sensor in some cases if it's strong enough. So you don't want to, if you're putting one of these vents in your bathroom and you have a shower, don't get one with a rain sensor for that. Now this one is the center of the trailer vent, so it does have a rain sensor. And by rain sensor, I mean it senses when there's rain and will close your vent for you automatically if there's water droplets actually getting inside the vent. If it's just a light rain and the vent's only partially open, it won't activate the sensor. Anyway, I went in here, decided, okay, I'm going to sit down and read these instructions because I've never installed one of these. I read enough before I wired the trailer to find out where the wires go. And then I figured, okay, well, if I need to read any more instructions, you know how men are. We don't like instructions. Listen, everything that you get, you should read completely through before doing an installation. And that also goes for any kind of chemicals that you're using, tools that you buy. I did a video on the multi-tool. I have my original first multi-tool that I ever bought still, and it still works great. A lot of people have told me that their multi-tool stopped working. The motor goes, but nothing happens. And that's because they break the little gears inside by not using 2 wrenches when they install their blades. So if you have a multi-tool, you want to read the instructions on how to maintain it, how to use it properly, how to install the blades without wrecking it. Well, same thing goes for the Fan-Tastic fan, except all you're going to get in this book is how to operate the fan. The only instructions are basically, yeah, they have installation for the battery, they have cleaning instructions, and, you know, things like that, but they only have 2 paragraphs for the how to install the thing instructions. Roof mounting instructions, original equipment, manufacturers, recommended screws. It actually comes with the screws, so you don't really have to worry about that. Anyway, it doesn't tell you much about how to install this thing. That's what my point is. So, here's the vent, okay? And it's got 2 wires coming out of it. And this thing comes with a couple of couplers. They're those little plastic blue couplers. And let me grab those. It also comes with the screws and with some extra wires, okay? So here's what it comes with. And you see these 2 little couplers in there? Those are those crimp type. So we're going to be using those. They do work well. You can't use wire nuts, regular wire nuts, because when you hook these wires up, then they have to slip back inside the fan. So in a little bit I'm going to show you the hole, and I already showed you how to cut the metal out last week for that. So in my other videos, there's, you know, in my framing videos, there's instructions on how to frame in for your vent. They're 14 inches by 14 inches on all vents, and I generally, except for the round ones, and I generally leave a total of 1/4 inch slop in both directions. You don't really need to because these things are all pretty darn square, but I do it anyway. So it gives you a little room for trim that's going to go up in there in case you're installing one of the regular vents with no fan. But these are the wire couplers, the crimp type. So basically one wire goes in here, your wire coming out of the vent, the other wire goes in there and you crimp it down. I'll show you that later. All right, so I've already wired the thing. I'm going to show you that now, and we'll be right back. All right, now as you'll see, the ends of these wires are already stripped for you, but they're much too long. So just pull the little thing off there the little piece of insulation that's there, and twist these up, and take your wire cutters, which I don't have here, of course. Remember, I just got done installing the one in the bathroom, so some of my stuff was in there. So take some wire cutters and cut these down to, a quarter inch. I don't want the excess to go in the fan, so I'll do it out here. Cut them down to a quarter inch. There you go. Then slip one of your barrel connectors all the way over. Twist it so it'll go in there. And then you need a crimper. Okay, these are crimpers. Let me see if I can see that okay. Yeah, these are crimpers. These are also strippers with different size wire gauges on them. And then I have cutters here with strippers on them with the different size wire gauges. I got a few different kinds. I'm an electrician by trade. So now this one, the really neat thing is about it, you can put screws in here and cut those also. And when you unscrew the screw, they're threaded in, so it keeps the threads good. So you can cut screws short with these also. The normal screws, normally the two size screws that are cut the most in electrical work is number 6, 32, and number 8, 32. These two here. So those are the screws that we use for most outlets and switches and things like that and fixtures. All right, so the very end is going to be the crimper for size 14 to 28 gauge barrel connectors. So we just slip it in there, end up just past the flange. Let me show you these again. Let me show you this one. There's a flange. See? So the insulation will go right up to there and stop. Okay? And then you want to crimp just beyond that flange. Alright, so put in there all the way. Get your connector on there, like, or your crimper on there like that, just outwards from the flange a little bit. Okay, and go ahead and squeeze it down tight. That'll make the connection. Now where's the other one? There it is. So we'll put our barrel on there like that. We'll get our crimper on there like that. Crimp it down. Okay. So that's the preparation for the wiring. And you'll notice, like I said, it had two slots. One here and one here. You can run your wires out either slot. I have opted to go with the default slot, which is this one. See, the hinge should be... Yeah, it's this one here. You want to look at where your hinge is. You always want your hinge facing forward on the trailer. That's so if you ever take off with the vent open, which you should not do, that's a no-no. Don't travel with the vents open. But if you do, because we all make mistakes, at least it'll be on the hinge side, it'll be the end of the wind, so it's at an angle into the wind. The wind will be going that way, and the vent will be open like halfway or straight up or whatever. Somewhere in there, and the wind will hit it that way, and it won't rip your vent off. If it was the other way and you took off into the wind, it'd rip the vent right off. It'd catch the wind really good. Alright, so go ahead and stick your wires hanging out here, basically. I'm going to put a piece of tape on there just to keep it in place. And actually, I don't even need to do that. You don't even have to have them sticking out of that thing there. Go ahead and shove them in here like that. All right, and now I'll put a piece of tape on. That's right. That's what I did. You want these wires inside when you go to drop your vent in there, because remember, it's going to come right down like that. And the other wires are going to be hanging out and go through this slot. So do this. Tape them down like that. And the next thing we're going to do is put our putty tape on there. All right, all you need for this process is a scissors and your putty tape. I'll start here so you can see. I use 2 layers of putty tape, 1/8 inch thick, 1 inch wide, on all my top vents. I even do it on some of the windows. It depends on what kind of pattern you have on your metal as to whether you want to do it on the windows or not. At any rate, we'll go ahead and start pulling our tape out here. Okay. And we'll run it out to the edge, okay, because you want to cover the screw holes. All right, there's screw holes there. You want to cover those. So run it all the way out to the edge, like so. Okay. By now you should have already learned all about putty tape with your J-rail and stuff, but if you haven't, you might own a trailer, you're just changing the vent in and want to know how to do it, so here you go. Now you want to make that stick. So run your fingers back and forth there with some pressure, okay? And then when you peel the paper back, this crinkly paper, do it like this. Don't pull straight up because you'll pull the tape off. Pull it straight back, 180 degrees back. Get rid of your paper. Okay, I'll go over here and do this one. Just go around in a circle doing this. We're gonna, when we put the second layer on, we will stagger our joints over these joints that are already here. That way you got no chance of water getting in, even if the putty tape shrinks. So, in other words, you'll see in a minute, when we start our next piece that goes this way, we'll start it back here and cross over that joint. Okay? So, again, make sure it's stuck good. Pull your paper straight back. Turn this guy again. Let's not get ahead of ourselves here. Okay, and one more time. Don't do this out in the blazing hot sun. Do it inside and then take it out there to your trailer if it's out in the sun. I'm lucky enough to have an indoor shop now. I don't have to worry about it. And that's all thanks to you guys. Because I really couldn't have done it without my viewers, the donations. They really helped a lot, me getting this shop and everything. As you know, it helped me get the big RV carport that I had over at the other place. And that was a great help. Of course, that only lasted a year and then I had to move. But I'm really glad they threw me out of there, because look what it's done for me. Okay, so that's our first layer. Now, as you can see, I think you can see here. Can you see? All right, as you can see here, hope this thing is focusing. The joint there, we're going to overlap that now. Start with our next one and go all the way across both these joints. That'll set the pace for overlapping all our joints. Okay, got that? All right, so we're going to do the same thing. We're going to, like I said, we're going to start right here, overlap that joint. Again, bring it all the way out to the edge. Now the second layer will stick better to itself, because that's what it's doing, sticking to other putty tape. Alright, so we start there and go all the way across. That sets the pattern. And really, what I want to do here is go turn it around 180 degrees. And wait a minute. Okay, turn it all the way around there. Alright, now we have to start here and go all the way across. So basically, you go backwards. Now I get confused, so you don't have to. Anyway, there we go. Yeah, we're going the opposite direction that we did before. Which makes sense, doesn't it? And this way we cover all the joints. Okay. So now we'll bring it over here. Do the same thing again. All the way. Don't worry about the excess, that'll come off later. It's the last thing we do. And then this piece will fit in between the last two joints. So you have to pre-cut it, sort of. Put it in there. Get it to stick. Come over here, line it up with the scissors, cut it. It's okay if it's a little long, you can just shove it in there. And there you go. Now we're ready to drop it in the hole. Now I also showed you in another video previously how to work on top of your trailer roof without hurting it. So two blocks, two 2x4 blocks, one for each side. Okay, we're going to put two here. And by each side, I mean, so we're going to put a 2x10, 2x10, 2x8. I've got 2x8s this time. We're going to put 2x8s across here from one edge to the other. So put your blocks all the way out here on the edge. Even have them hanging out a quarter inch. That's so that you put all your weight, for sure, on the curb and not inward of the curb where you'll do damage. And spread them out so that you got, well, at least 4 inches on either side of the vent hole. Okay, do that here. I hope you can see that. I think you can. Do it on the other side. Here I'm using bigger ones because I have to span over the vent hole for the refrigerator. Remember, let them hang back a quarter inch, okay, over the edge. Don't worry, it won't fall. It won't fall. Now we take our 2x8s. And these are very heavy because they're not. I had some older ones back home that were all dried out and lightweight. These are kind of heavy, so because they're not, they're brand new. So you want to be careful because you don't want to scratch the top. First, I'm going to lay it up there. I'm going to hold it out as far as I can without falling off this ladder. Get it to the other side. Boy, hard to do. One more time. There we go. All right, move it in a little bit. It's kind of far away. You don't want to slide it on top because that'll probably scratch your paint. I wish these were dried out, so I'm going to be a lot lighter. Put your ladder in as close as you can to the trailer. I'm going to say it's a lot easier when they're lighter. Now this one I'm going to slide on the other board so I don't scratch it. I'll just have to twist it. All right. that, see? Well, I get it there. I'll leave it there and then go to the other side again. This side, see now, it's nice because the other block did not travel on me. The board slid on it instead. All right, so I have this one placed. And I'm going to bring it in a little closer. You only want maybe 2 or 3 inches outside the vent hole. All right, and place this one. And it's out a little far, so I'll adjust it. You can adjust it after you get it all up here. There, now we're ready to climb up there. You can also put blocks across here, pieces of wood across here, if you want to. I don't have anything put across here right now, but in my previous video, you'll see that I had a piece of 3/4 inch plywood up there that I could work on. But this will work for me for right now. So, because I want to get up from this, I'm going to get this out of my way. Okay. There we go. Now ready to work. So I'm going to grab the vent, being careful not to touch the putty tape if I can, because you don't want to hurt that. Bring it up here. All right, I'll set it over here. And it's going to go this way. Let's see, this way. Wait, nope. Remember the hinge towards the front. I had it right to begin with. Hinge towards the front. And now I'll climb up on top of here and just hope that the cameras are all pointed in the right spot. And I need to get the little GoPro going too. All right, now as you can see, I've already wired this. And you want to use 14 gauge wire. They tell you to use a minimum of 16 gauge. I use 14 gauge. 14 gauge is thicker. So I don't like to undercut my wiring. I want to make sure there's no fires, and I want to make sure nothing melts. So I used 14 gauge, and you can run a longer run, although these wires don't have to go very far. They only go right down to there. So if you open up the box, you can see that there are two outlets for the wire to come out, and the default outlet, and by outlet I mean just a little hole, for the wire to come out of the fan itself. The measurement is right here. It's about 3 inches in. So, and it's right up here in the middle. So, you have to remember that I have a 3/4 inch crown around here. So, here's the ceiling framing. And then there's a 3/4 inch crown on top of that to raise the metal up so that nothing puddles around it. It doesn't hurt, doesn't cause any buckling or anything. You always want to do that on your top vents. Always, even the round ones, you want to make sure you have this 3/2 inch to 3/4 inch curb. The closer it is to the edge of the trailer, the harder it is to get the metal around it when you're doing the fold over. So if it's real close to the curb, only go 1/2 inch for your curb, for your crown, I mean. Alrighty, so we got the wires coming out here about 3 inches in. And right in the middle between the crown and the ceiling framing, and they're 14 gauge. So let's go back over to the vent now, and I'll start preparing the vent for insulation. So, I got the hinge towards the front. I'm going to grab this thing by the lid, pretty much, and just drop it right down in the hole. Should fit. Although my, there we go. Of course, the other one fit. There we go. Have to jimmy with it a bit. All right, it's in the hole. Hinges forward. Ta-da! I'm going to carefully get down. Let's see why I have two boards up here. Be careful doing this. You don't want to hurt yourself. I have two boards up here because I want to be on both sides to be able to put the screws in. I'll readjust this one. All right. All right, now the first thing you want to do before you do anything else is center this in the hole. All right, so it's a little crooked, and that'll make your trim crooked if you leave it like that. And I just like to have it centered. So it's easy enough to do using this little cat's paw. All right. Got an even space on both sides. Grab it in the corners, that's where it's strongest. And we're there. And you can see that I got my wires coming out here. And they're already stripped and ready to go in here into these guys. All right. So I'll grab my crimps. Remember the crimps? And we'll put the white wire. Now the white wire, as with our trailer lights, the white wire, come on, get in there. There. The white wire is negative. And the black wire is positive in trailers and trailer lighting. It's not like that everywhere else, just in trailers. So don't get confused and hook it up backwards. I don't think it'll hurt it, but all your controls will be wrong. Then crimp it just like we did before. Okay, that's one. Slide this one into the barrel. All right. Crimp that one. Okay. Now make sure they're good and tight. Now you're going to like this move. This is pretty simple. Now you just slide the wires up in there into that little space. The frame, that's why they use these barrel connectors, because they'll slip up in there, see? Whereas if you use wire nuts, they won't. So you basically just slide those up in there and make sure that these wires coming out of the framing go up into the slot. Now you can use a screwdriver or your cat's paw to help get wires up in there. Okay. Because they'll slide up out of the way. And you want to get into where this slot is, all right, and get the wires to go up in there, like that. There we go. Just slide them up out of the way. What will happen is your trim will push them the rest of the way, so that's why you want this to be, these wires to be in the slot that is in the side of the fan housing. So make sure that they are there. All right, now I'm going to go back on top and put four screws in, one in each corner. Because when I go to put the housing up here, I don't want to push the fan back up out of its place. So I'll be right back. Okay, now I'm just using these screws that come with it. They're gray on top. They're flat screws, beveled. See that? Okay. I'm going to put one in each corner, just keep it from popping up when I go to push the cover on from the bottom. One in each corner. Then you can come back and finish screwing everything down later. Now don't smush it down too much yet. You want to do that gently and slowly over the course of putting all the other screws in. Just get it down enough to hold it there. and leave that screw gun up here. Alright, now this is always fun. Trying to screw something up to the ceiling, hold it there and screw it at the same time. You need like three arms. But there's some plastic left in these holes, which makes it a little convenient. You can put your screw in there and get it started. So do that with two of them opposite each other. See? That one doesn't want to hold. That was not enough plastic. So we got one anyway. And so that'll get us started. So I'm going to put that out away from my face. And here we go. It just slides right up in over in between where you shove those wires. Okay, and you got to be a little forceful with it where the wire side is. But not much. See that? There we go. Now, I'm tall enough where I can hold it with my head. If you're not tall enough, you might want to get something to stand on. Let's get it started. Gotta get another screw in the opposite corner. Okay. Don't tighten them too far. Should be wood underneath your ceiling paneling. Now, I already tested the wiring earlier to make sure everything was had continuity and voltage there and everything. You might want to do that before you go through all this trouble. You might even want to put the ceiling fan in before you put your side metal on. Now, here's where you get a little forceful on the wire side. Beat on it a bit to get that up there. And then tighten up that screw. Don't strip it. And there is the Fan-Tastic fan ceiling vent. This one has a motorized rain sensored vent top, and so it opens and closes with a motor, or you can and you can adjust the rain sensor. It's all in the instructions. The fan will also go in two directions right here. I'll show you all this in a minute. Then here's, I think this is your speed control to on off. I don't know what this switch does yet because I got to read the instructions, but and this is how you open the vent. Now you can either do it manually like that, or you can, which is slow, or you can use a motor, which is the best way to do it. All right, I'm going to keep using this camera, and here I think I'll first, yeah, I think I'll just grab it. Okay, so this switch here opens the vent. Isn't that cool? Now, if you don't have the rain sensor with the motor, then you would just use this handle, which you can use anyway if your batteries are dead. It's just slow going. Now, to turn the fan off and on, well, this is direction and also the off button. Okay, that's sucking air out. And then over here is your speed control. There it is, all the way off. Okay, takes a long time to slow down, but we'll put it on low. Okay, now you can turn it off. If you want to change direction, wait till it stops. It's hard on the motor if you don't. Good ball bearings, huh? All right, now you can go the other way, and it'll blow air in. It's, I think it's blowing air in. Yeah, it is. It's blowing air in. All right. And then this guy over here is a temperature control. You can set the temperature for in here. So not only does it have rain sensor, but it has a temperature sensor. And you can turn this to wherever you want it so that if it gets too warm in here, this thing will come on all by itself and suck the heat out. So let's go ahead and put it on the heat sucker outer mode. And you'll notice it's not working now. Let's see, I have it turned on. And that's because it's not warm enough yet, according to this thing. And I guess it'll never get warm enough in here because it's not warm in here. But I set it to where if it gets any warmer than it is now, it'll come on. Okay, so I guess that does work. I'm new to these things too. So this is your temperature control. There, you can see I just, now it went off. And if it gets hotter in here, it'll come back on. So let's say it's getting hotter. There, it comes back on. And then what happens is, if it starts raining and the rain sensor feels water, I'm going to simulate that by just turning, bringing the vent back down and closing it. It'll do this. It'll turn the fan off, and it'll suck the vent down tight. So isn't that cool? So I think it's worthwhile to have, because every single old trailer I've ever found, either the vent was open when I found it, or, it was gone, especially the plastic ones. And it had rained in there for years, and the floor underneath it was damaged. So people forget. They leave their vents open. It happens all the time. So this is great for you forget-me-nots or you forgetful people that need to be able to walk away and leave your vent open. And then if it rains, it'll automatically close. The only thing left up here to look at is this is the fuse. You can change that fuse if you need to. So I'm going to go up here and put the rest of the screws in now. So there's your installation on the Fan-Tastic fans. Same applies for regular vents. You just don't have all the electrical and all that stuff, but it's done the same way. So this is Larry, Mobile Tech with CanDamTrailers.com. I hope you got something out of this video. I want to remind you that I've got Patreon going now. I'm a member of the system. And if you feel like supporting me, just click on the P that you'll see up in one of these corners here at the end of the video. And you can go there along with all my other new patrons that are supporting me. You can join in on the club and you'll get a lot of extra content that my regular viewers don't get to see. That only the patrons get to see. This video is going out to all my viewers. So don't worry, all my regular videos will still be free. And you'll still get plenty of free content. But if you want extra content, special content, and you want to support me, Patreon is a much easier way to do it. And like I say, you get extra content. The stickers just came in, so I'm going to send those out to my new patrons. And here's a list of all my new patrons, as a matter of fact, somewhere on this screen. So again, this is Larry, Mobile Tech, signing off. Happy trails, and be safe. Remember to wear eye protection, ear protection if you need it, a face mask if you need it, gloves if you need them. Wear all that stuff. You may not see me do it all the time. And I actually do it. I use that stuff. I use protective clothing and everything a lot more than you think. It's just when I'm doing the camera work, it's one of the things that's not on my mind. I don't always think about it. So always use eye protection if nothing else. Happy trails. We'll see you later. Getting old for this.